These images taken by the Our Trees We Need Answers activists show an endless land with freshly cut trees. They depict the true extent of the ongoing indiscriminate tree cutting in Acholi subregion and beyond. These trees have been cut down in order to produce charcoal. It is in this line that the environmental activists under their umbrella body, Our Trees We Need Answers, are seeking for the attention of the Ministry of Environment and Natural Resources, the Parliament of Uganda, to strengthen the existing laws in the fight against environmental destruction being caused by illegal charcoal businesses.
In the judiciary, but it starts from Parliament that makes the laws. So we are lying with Father Onen, for example, and we're saying let's borrow from other pieces of legislation, even fisheries. Fisheries today, look at how the army, they deploy the army, by the way, on the lakes and in certain rivers. You don't just go and mess about with the fish we have. Yeah. We're saying let this also be done with our trees that we have in this region.
Arthur Owo is an academician, the founder of the Center for African Research. He is also the coordinator of these environmental activists. Our Trees We Need Answers.
We're saying now the directive has come. With or without its loopholes, we are saying we need to engage further. Let her come down, we're going to engage her further and we'll talk and see how to tighten settlement those existing loopholes. But we, as Our Trees, we appreciate the spirit behind that direction.
On the 24th of January 2023, the Minister of State for Environment, Beatrice Anyua, released a letter banning the issuance of all types of documents that facilitate the commercial production and trade of charcoal in the Acholi subregion.
There must be a penalty. I've interacted with police. It seems even police is finding it hard to implement this directive because there's no penalty.
Benson Ongom is a journalist and an ardent environmental activist. Together with the other environmental activists, they request the Minister of State for Environment, Beatrice Anyua, to camp in the northern Uganda in order to fully understand the extent of the problem being caused by illegal charcoal businesses. The most affected districts are Amuru, Gulu and Agago. Trees here, especially the cherry shianut and Azalea africana, have been cut without mercy.
And as men of God, I think it's about the time we begin also as we minister the word of God, as we get into our sermons, to tell our people that it is very, very important to conserve and then protect our environment, because this is a looming danger. It is a timing bomb that we are all seated on, and does not discriminate whether we are men of God, whether we are not religious.
Reverend Nelson Obol, the Provisional Gulu City Overseer of the National Born Again Pentecostal Churches, has joined the movement. The environmental activists want stakeholders to join hands in curbing the ongoing indiscriminate tree cutting in Acholi subregion and beyond. Arthur Owo is further calling for the protection of environmental activists who have become a target for the people who are involved in the illegal charcoal business.
There are a series of youth in Amuru, about 8 of them. Yesterday we had, they were brought to court, and the duty bearers continue, sometimes even going to the extent of swearing, that they're going to pursue the matter to the last detail. We think they also need to swear and be on record to say they are going to protect the environment to the last detail. So we find it problematic, and there are some problem districts that we have named.
Others are claiming to be transporters, but they are national leaders. So that means they are also supporting it. So we call upon them that let's stop this. And we want to have a mitigation with all the players in this.
According to the NEMA letter dated the 18th of April 2023, the authority has not issued an environmental and social impact assessment certificate to anyone for charcoal production. And as such, the ongoing commercial charcoal production across the country is illegal. Reporting for the news, I am Joseph Omagor in Gulu City.